Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see how to use Apache Sling Request Processing Analyzer to analyze the recent request in AEM. The recent request is a very useful feature on the OSI Felix console to know what is going on at each request, how the resources are resolved by Sling, and the time taken to load the sub-resources. This will help us to debug the resource resolution issues and also to capture the time taken to process the resources. By default, 20 recent requests are captured into the recent request console. The recent request console can be accessed through this URL systemconsole/requests. So let me do that. If you see max 20, so recorded 20 requests. By default, 20 recent requests will be recorded here. The value, the number of requests to record, so this max 20, whatever displayed here, can be changed in Apache Sling main servlet through OSI console. So this is URL to access this. If I go here, if you see here, number of requests to record is 20. So also this recorded request path patterns can be also changed to only capture the paths that matches the pattern. So example, if you say you want to capture only the JSON request, so you can just say the pattern saying star JSON, so whatever ends with JSON.json will be captured. So here this number of request record, you can change it to whatever the value you require. So let me change it to 30. Okay, let me go back here. So this will take some time to reflect this change. Yeah, this will show us a 404 initially, because we done a change in that particular configuration. It will take to reflect. Let me wait for maybe 2 seconds. Reflected now. So now if you see this max 30, so change to max 30. Now it will capture the 30 recent request. But unfortunately, this will not help us to trace millions of requests through this console, and also only the recent values will be shown based on the configuration. So again, sometimes we may need to analyze huge request during the load testing or some other cases to identify the time taken by the individual request and to identify the request that taking more time to process. Okay, Sling Request Processing Analyzer helps to achieve whatever the scenarios I am explained. Sling Request Processing Analyzer locks all the each request in a specific file. So the file name is going to be this requesttracker.txt. So also that file will be created under the locks folder. So this is going to capture some of the details as like this: start timestamp, request processing time in millisecond, request method, request URL, response content type, also the content in character encoding if it is available, then response status. So after that, the request progress tracer data will be dumped. So now let's see how to configure this request processing analyzer. So the request processing analyzer can be downloaded from here, this particular URL from the GitHub. So I already downloaded. So there you can even do a checkout also. So I just downloaded this and I extracted already. Now as a next step, we need to build this and install it. So let me do that. Let me go to a command prompt. CD. Let me select command open. Install. This may take 2-3 minutes. Okay, now the bundle is ready. Now we need to install this bundle. Let me go to the bundles. Okay, let me install it. Install start bundle. Choose the bundle. It will be in this in the target folder. So I select the snapshot package. Install. Okay, let me refresh the page. search for request process analyzer. Yes, it's active. So now if you go to the logs folder from the server, CRX quick start, go to logs, you would have created a folder request tracker with 0 GB. There is nothing, no data captured. So now, let us see how to use this. So for that, I am going to access this particular some URL, random URL. Okay. Now, if I go back to this logs folder, if you see, if you see 699 KB. Now let us see how to analyze this particular request tracker file. So for that, what we need to do is we need to execute this particular command. So jar, where is the jar is available, the same snapshot.jar whatever we installed, you can point to the same jar, then this txt file. So I will go into this logs folder. So maybe go to crx logs, then I will execute this particular command. This will open a Java Sling GUI. So let's wait for 2 seconds. Yeah, so if you see here, this displayed all this data. If you see here, the start time, then the duration, then method, URL, then content type and status. So this will display for all the URL. Now if I randomly click on one URL, this will show the complete progress trace. So this will help you to identify what is the issue and how much time each sub resources are taking. So in case of you want to debug any issues. Okay, so there is another way to debug, another way to analyze this log also. So for that, what we need to do is, let me close this. We can go into this particular URL, system console request analyzer. I'll go there. Yeah, so if you see here request tracer.txt, you can just click. Yeah, this will show you a txt file, but this is just for reference. But here if you go back, there is a action, so just to click analyze now. The same that Sling GUI will be opened, and with all the details are going to be same. It will display all these details, and click on this, it will show the individual trace. Okay, that's it for today. We configured the Apache Sling request process analyzer in AEM, and we learned how to use that to analyze the request processing. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.